All right, what I'd like to do is show you guys how to graph a normal distribution and calculate the probability based on z-scores. So the first step is to go to y equals, and then we're going to go and click on second, and then vars, which pulls up the distributions. You could do a t-distribution, chi-squared, all the distributions, really. But we just want to do a normal distribution, so we're going to say normal PDF. For here, just leave it at 0, 0, and the standard deviation of 1. And what that's going to do is it's going to plug some numbers in here. Now, on an older calculator, you could just enter in x. But on this newer version, you can't do that. But if I delete everything and plug an x in, then and the other thing you need to do is make sure that you go into the window and go from negative 4 to 4. And then your x scale should probably be at 1. So clear that out, put that at 1. And then for your y value, you want a little bit below 0. So I put negative 0.1 and then about the halfway. So I put 0.5 as my y max. Then if I hit graph, it graphs a normal distribution. Now to find the area under the curve, there's two ways you could do it. You could do a cumulative distribution graph. Or what I found that works best is if I go in and I hit second program, which pulls up the draw, I can draw and calculate the area under the curve. Actually, I take that back. You know, you could just calculate the area under the curve because this is a function. So what I will do is I will hit second trace and go to option number 7. I'll just scroll down here and integrate that based on the z-score. Now, because I said that my standard deviation was 1 and 0 was the x value and that mu was 0 as well, I have a normal distribution that goes, the z-score should be whatever you have entered in. In other words, if we use the empirical rule, if I evaluate from, say, negative 1 to positive 1, then based on the empirical rule, I should get about 68%. So the area under the curve is 0.6826. The reason I wanted to hit the draw menu at first is in order to get rid of this area under the curve, I could just hit second program for draw and then just clear my drawing by hitting option number 1, and that'll clear that out. So for example, remember in the empirical rule, if I go plus or minus, whoops, let me graph that real quick. If I hit second trace, option number 7, and I go from negative 2 to 2, remember that that's going to be about 95% under the area under the curve, or 0.95. And sure enough, it is. From negative 2 to 2, I've got 0.9544987. We could do that one more time and hit second trace. And if I choose option number 7 and we go from negative 3 to positive 3, that should be 99.7. And it is 0.997 or 99.7% of the area under the curve. And so that's how you would find the distribution or the probability based on standard deviation.